you know, my dear brothers and sisters, when we share the word of God, maybe it will help you. I mean, maybe it will encourage you. Some people may get offended when we say certain words. I remember one lady sent a message to me some months ago. That was this: Father, my husband and me, we always used to watch this live streaming. But one day when you spoke against alcohol, that day he told me, now onwards, I don't want to watch it. And he switched off the TV from then. So now I'm watching it alone in my mobile. That is what she said. My dear brothers and sisters, we have a tendency to only be comfortable with what is comfortable for us. When we listen to certain words of God which are not comfortable for us, we get irritated and disturbed. That is with most of the human beings. My dear brothers and sisters, we should not change the word as we want. The word of God should be preached as it is. The intention of God is more important than my intention or your intention. God wants us to be holy. That's all. God, we may find out excuses to find out some excuse to have our own pleasure and enjoyment. That is our intention. We read like this in the word of God. Proverbs chapter 30 verse 5. Proverbs chapter 30 verse 5. Every word of God proves true. Every word of God is proof wrong. The proofs right, true. It will never be wrong. Every word of God in the past, that is written in the past from the Genesis. If you look into that word of God, you must have already noticed in the last 10, 9, 11 months, you know, as you are listening to the preaching between the Old Testament, New Testament comparison, you must have seen all the words that is preached in the spoken in the Old Testament came true in the life of Jesus and in New Testament. And all what is written in the Old Testament and also in the Bible is taking place now. So for all the things that is taking place around, you can see the word of God is already given to us. So every word of God proves true. He is a shield to those who take refuge in Him. So if you take this word of God seriously and obey it, then God becomes a shield in front of you. You know, God will defend you. God will be a shield for you. Verse 6. Do not add to His words. Do not add to His words. Or else He will rebuke you and you will be found a liar. So don't add something to the word of God. Many a time I've seen people misquoting the Bible just to justify their evil intention. They want something to enjoy, so they quote Bible. There are people who are addicted to alcohol. They quote the wedding at Cana, turning water into wine as a big refuge for them to depend on. And they quote saying, Jesus turned water into wine, why can't I drink? So these are all, you know, we are adding our own ideas to the words. I've already explained to you the reason, the transformation, I mean, the miracle of the wedding at Cana in one of the preachings previously given. So my dear brothers and sisters, we have no right to add or remove anything from His word. Sometimes when we take the word of God as it is, when we understand the intention of God, it may convict us. It may be disturbing us. But don't worry, let it disturb us. Let it bring something good out of us. Because God's word is constructive. Our words only destructive. So be very careful not to use the word of God in wrong places with wrong intentions. Because word of God has its own intention, the intention of Jesus. We should not use it for our intention.